Today, we're going to put Lovable, the AI app and website builder, and Card to the test to see which one is best for you when it comes to building a landing page. We have featured both of these tools prominently on the channel, and by the end of the video, you'll have a good idea about which one is best to use when it comes to building a simple landing page. So let's get started with Lovable by giving it a prompt, and then we'll choose a starting point for Card after that. So the prompt is a landing page for a freelancer who wants to sell consultations for the social media marketing consultancy. So we'll send that prompt away. While that's happening, we'll just start with Card. So I have a Card Pro account, which is very reasonable. I'll link to the pricing in the description, but we're going to choose a starting point here. And the key to Card is starting with a template. And then from there, you can easily adapt the template in order to make it perfect for you. You can choose from profile, landing, form, portfolio, and sectioned. So we'll start with a landing page, and we'll just go with this one because I like the colors and select this. Here you can see this is a drag and drop builder that whenever you click on any of the elements, you can then edit these elements on the left. And we'll continue with this in a moment. We're just going to go back to Lovable and see what it's come up with. Now, this took about 5 minutes to complete, but you can see on your screen that it has created this landing page. And I'm just going to open a preview in a new tab so we can have a look at this properly. So it's created the title. You can just see here also it has buttons. If we click these buttons, nothing is working right now. That's because you need to do some extra integrations here. And as we scroll down, we can see that it's added all of these different content areas as well. And it's given us a name of Sarah Chen. But all in all, you can see that this is a very typical AI created landing page from Lovable. And one thing that I think is quite important here is that it's done a lot of the copy for us. Now, if we wanted this to be tailored towards us, we could have created a PRD. I'll leave a link in the description about how to do that so that the prompt is stronger and it's going to create something more personalized towards you and what you do. But obviously these are placeholders with these testimonials, but it gives you a good idea about what you can include on here. And it's done a lot of the copy for you. And I think that is an underrated aspect of some of the AI app builders. And to make edits to this, we can click the edit button down here on the left and then click the different elements and then simply just change the text like this. So if we want to say viral machine, we can do that too. And then another great feature of Lovable is that you can click the chat here. And this is great for anything that you want to ask Lovable without changing the code to it. So here, I know a lot of people get stuck when it comes to trying to integrate forms into here, how to connect it to a database if that is needed, and how to deploy it. Because I think this is a sticking point when it comes to creating these landing pages, in that a lot of it is done through the AI agent rather than, as we're going to see with Card, through a more traditional way of using a no-code tool. So I'll send off this prompt and then I'll go back to Card. Just a very quick overview of Card. You can click on any element and change both the text here, but also the appearance of it too. So we can increase the title, we can change the font, and we can change the color of the font too. And then as we go back to the text, we can enter our text in here and then click done. Now, I think one of the benefits of using Card is when you click on an element like button, you can open this up here and simply send people to a Calendly link here or to wherever it may be. But you can also click the add element button here, embed a form. And then when you've done that, you can change the fields of the form. You can click change the button text. Again, the appearance here. And I'm not a big fan of this appearance. Luckily, we can easily change that. And you can connect something like MailChimp, MailerLite, ActiveCampaign, and other email marketing software tools. Additionally, we can click on any element and simply delete it. Click yes. And then those contents are now gone. So for example, we can click this button, delete this button, and then we've got our name and email here. Additionally, add in something like click widget, and then we have a Stripe checkout, Gumroad, and PayPal that we can use for payment. So if you have something like Gumroad, you can click Gumroad, and then simply add in your product details here and the button label here. And let's say we don't like this template to begin with. Instead of asking AI to come up with a new style and add in new colors and fonts, we can go back to the different templates and simply just choose one that we prefer. For example, this one is a bit more simple. We can add our image in here, again, delete the button, and then add a Gumroad buy button here. Now, After asking Lovable how to integrate MailChimp with this book free consultation button down here, it's telling me that there are three options. You can use MailChimp's marketing API directly from the front end, and it's saying that this is less secure. You can do a back-end integration via Superbase, which is recommended. And option three is to use MailChimp's embedded form code, and you can replace your current button with MailChimp's form. I also asked it to replace those buttons with a Gumroad Buy Now button in the Hero section. And it's given me again the different integration options. So there's a Gumroad overlay, which is recommended. And at the bottom, it says implement the Gumroad integration plan, which I'll click, and I'll come back with the results of this. So what it's done is it has integrated that, as you can see here with the buy button, and it's saying replace your product ID with your actual Gumroad product ID. So there are further steps that you need to do in order to completely implement this. I'm just going to make one more change and say edit, button, trash, delete. And now you can see how Lovable does have some traditional no-code editing capabilities where you can delete the button, and then it does actually center this button too. And if we click edit to a section, can also delete this section too if we want to just get rid of all of that. So I'll do that now, and as you can see, that has deleted that section. So going back to card, in order to continue with this, what I would do is use ChatGPT to come up with some of the copy here and then edit that copy. And then to deploy or to publish this, you can click this button, enter the title, and you can have a subdomain on card. Or you can buy your own domain and follow the instructions in order to have this go live as a website. Whereas with Lovable, you need to integrate the backend and the Superbase account and then follow the deploy instructions here. So which one is best for you, and which one are you going to use? Personally, I'm stuck in two minds here because I think it's a lot quicker to get the results that you want from Lovable from simple prompts, especially if you start off with a stronger prompt instead of just a simple one here. If you create a PRD, and I'll leave a link on how to do that in the description, then it can come up with something much closer to what you want first time of asking. Whereas card, it takes a little while to go through the different templates, but I find introducing buttons and having control over the editing is a lot easier on something like card. And also when it comes to deploying, integrating Gumroad, integrating MailChimp. So what are your thoughts on this? Let us know in the comments. And if you want to learn more about Lovable or card, then check out the playlist in the description and on your screen now, so that you can go through all of our tutorials, and then go to sascourse.ai to get your first free lesson on how to build your own products with AI. Thank you for watching, and we'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.